Okay, so check out these sweet mouse effects. Look at how everything interacts with where my mouse is moving. You can see a number of things going on. Let's start with the obvious thing here, which is the emoji. All of it is following at its own pace. The text here is moving in different, you can kind of see it's kind of angling depending on the perspective of your mouse. And I also want to show you how to make this one. So this one's just like some creepy AI art that I generated in Wix Studio, and all of them kind of interact with your mouse. So you can kind of hop the cowboy around. The cow also kind of moves and tilts and pans. And then the sun kind of moves away from your mouse. So as I move down, the sun goes up. As I move to the right, it twists to the left. And then the third and final example, I wanted to give you something that was practical. The movements are a little more subtle here. And so the decorative elements on the right, you know, they do interact with the mouse. As you can see, all the elements do something. So these are the three cool demos that I want to show you how to make. It's really, really fast. All you need is a free Wix Studio account. And I actually provided some one-click install library that installs each of these demos without any of the mouse effects. And then I'll show you how to add them. Super easy. So sign up for a Wix Studio account. It's the advanced platform for web design agencies who want to build websites for clients. It's for helping you grow and build your web design agency. You can deliver amazing results to your clients, all with no code, but you can also code if you want. These effects require zero code. Brand new feature in Wix Studio just dropped, and I want to show you how to do it. The link in the description is going to take you to this page right here, and it's going to say, add the mouse effects workshop library to your account. Once you have your Wix Studio account, accept that library. So click the link and accept the library. You got to start up a fresh site. You can just click new site when you go to your Wix Studio account. And I just have a site here. I'm going to go to just like an empty page right here. And that library, you'll be able to find under add elements. If you go down to assets, you can see under your libraries, you should have one called Mouse Effects Workshop. So I'm just going to take this first one, Sandbox one, drag it on the screen and replace this middle section here. We're going to start with this face because this is the most exciting part. And in our layers panel, you see how it's set up. We have a container called yellow guy, and then we have the left eye and the right eye, and each eye has some shapes, which are just circles of different colors and sizes. Selecting the yellow head. So that's the basic shape. It's yellow. And over in my inspector panel over here, I'm going to go to animations and effects down to mouse effects. This is brand new. Add, and honestly, it's as simple as this. You can choose any of these mouse effects right here. And so the one that I am going to use is just track. It just tracks the mouse. You can click that and then adjust animation. Now you can actually test it right here on the screen in your dashboard. Now, obviously, I don't want that. I want it to be subtle. You can do whatever you want here. There's no hard and fast rules of how to exactly achieve this effect. Play around with it and experiment. That's the funnest part. But I would recommend something like having a small distance, like 20 pixels. So now it's only going to move a small distance. And then the velocity, if I show you, if it's at full, it moves real slow. It's kind of got a slow, well, it's got less velocity or more velocity. I don't really know how that works. If the number is higher, it's going to take kind of more, it's going to be a slower speed in tracking the mouse. And if it's all the way to the left at zero, it's going to literally track it 1-to-1. So I like this one to be, what I want is the larger elements to have a higher number of velocity and the smaller elements to have a faster velocity. Because I feel like if you're looking at a perspective at a screen and you're on kind of like a, like you've got like kind of like a plane of like a field of view. What's the word? Plane of view, field of view, anatomical plane, plane of view, field of plane. Is it aviation? Okay, I don't know what I'm looking at anymore. The elements further away move slower. The elements closer to move faster. It's kind of like the true parallax style effect. And so that's what we want. So now select an eyeball, but don't select the container. We want to drill down further. We want to select the actual, the white of the eyeball. So under your layers, you actually be able to see this better. And so we can name this, you know, that would have been probably better. So I'm actually just going to select this. This is going to be called the white. This one's going to be called the black. And this is going to be called the pupil. So now we understand. So I'm going to select the white, and that's going to have a mouse effect as well. And that's going to be track, adjust it. And obviously that's not going to work. So we're going to make the distance of this one a little bit more than the yellow. So the yellow was 20. We're going to make this one 30. So it's going to move a bigger distance than the yellow head. And the velocity, we want it to be, let's make it like a 2. Perfect. And the movement axis, we want it to be both. You can make it just horizontal or vertical if you just want it to move on the x-axis or the y-axis, like that. Or like that. That made me dizzy. Now, what I'm going to do here is select the black part, and we're going to give that another mouse effect. Track, adjust the animation. The distance, again, we're going to make this 35, a little bit more than the white part. The velocity of this one, we'll make it 2. Okay. Now, if we want, we can test this to see how it's looking so far in context. I'm going to preview that. Yeah, that works for me. Now I'm going to select the white part, or the pupil rather, and mouse effect, track. The distance of that is going to be, I think it was 35. I should remember my numbers here. And then this one will be like 1. There we go. That works great. Now you can see the other one is not actually moving. So what we can do is either duplicate this eye and put it into position, or remember all the numbers. I'm actually going to do the former. You can kind of drag it wherever you want, but what we need to remember here is that it is in the inspector panel under design. We want it not to be docked to anything. We want it just floating here, because then it will scale proportionally as we resize the screen. And so now if I preview this, we've got the whole head and the eyes following the mouse. Very cool. And as you can see here, you're on the page. That is just so cute and creepy. Now, play around with this. You could select one of the elements like this one, mouse effects, add. And what if we did something like obscure? That's like super cool. Different from the demo I showed you, because I don't remember what I did. Moving on, let's go to the next one. Another page, add a new page. Just click add new page, clean empty page, delete this, whatever you want to do. So here's my empty page right here. I'm going to go to add assets, mouse effects workshop. I'm going to take my second one here. Replace the middle section, drop it in, whatever works. We've got our three elements right here. And what I want to do is, well, let's first of all make sure that that header is brought to the front. So our sun is behind it. Perfect. Now just select an element, select the cow, and turn on your inspector panel, animations and effects, choose a mouse effect, choose whatever you want. You can make it a blob, you can obscure it, you can track it in 3D. Let's track it in 3D, see what happens. Okay, the cow's like kind of going a little wild there. Little much. Let's make the distance smaller, 75. That looks good to me. Perspective, you can drag it all the way down and it'll really stretch that perspective. Wait, there we go. It'll really stretch it out and get real obnoxious. That's cool. Let's take our Cowboy Tom over here, mouse effects. Let's turn on some mouse effects here. And let's make Cowboy Tom, let's track him in, no, let's do airy. And we're gonna do the velocities all the way down and the distance. I like the long distance here. Let's do like 600. And this will like pretty much allow him to like track your mouse. Fun and weird. Love it. Select the sun, mouse effects, add. This one's going to be like, we're going to do, let's do airy again, but I'm actually going to invert the mouse direction. There we go. And let's make the velocity a little more sluggish and the distance like small. It's so silly. I don't know in what scenario we'd need to do this other than like give your kids the mouse and let them play around with your website. Now let's go on to the third example, something more practical. Let's select this little asterisk graphic vector out here. Mouse effects, add, let's obscure it. And let's like go real wacky here. We're gonna go invert, we're gonna blur it hardcore. Oh yeah. We're gonna make the angle like real intense. Scale, you can make the scale. If it's a smaller number, it's gonna get real small as you move away. Or you can have it be kind of more to scale and it will stay the same size regardless of where the mouse is. Cool. Select a little arrow here, mouse effects, add. Let's make it, I don't know, resize. Should we do that one? Yeah, resize. Let's have it expand as we get further away. That's fun. And we'll have it follow the mouse. The velocity is going to be a little more sluggish and the size, not too big. There we go. So it's like it's bigger as you get further away, smaller as you get closer. Let's actually invert it so it gets bigger as you get further away, smaller as you get closer. Perfect. Next element, this little oval down here, mouse effects, add blob, because it's a blob. I'm not going to even change anything. I like it as is. And then finally, this little container user interface element, mouse effects, add. I'm actually going to have it track in 3D. And yeah, I'm going to have it follow the mouse. So it's like looking at you like that. But I'm actually going to have the angle be a little less. No, I actually want the angle to be big. So it really kind of has that. Yeah, that's cool. It really looks like it's following you and looking at you. Cool. And then the distance, we don't want it to go too far from its position. The velocity a little bit slower, like it's reacting to where you're going. Boom. There it is like that. Simple as that. Nothing crazy in terms of making it. It's so easy to make. If you like this tutorial, then join our community. It's called the Creative Crew Community. The link is in the description and the pinned comment down below. We have a workshop on this where you can play around with this a little bit further. We do workshops, we bring in guest experts, and we have lots of great exclusive content within the community. It's totally free. Come join us if you want to learn how to build and grow and scale your web design business with us. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time.